Hey, this is Maya Dasilva, and this is my interview with Children of Zeus. We spoke about their album Balance, which is out now on all streaming platforms. Make sure you subscribe to Unity Radio on YouTube for more.
So was most of this music written during lockdown, or was some of this had in the back work, ready to go?
I'd say about 85% was the last year.
Definitely, yeah.
We just didn't have time previous to that to pre-lockdown. We were just touring, so we didn't really make a lot of music.
Yeah.
So most of it was written in the last year.
Yeah.
Okay. So what is your creative process like? Do you guys work quite closely together, or is it a studio separate and you guys send it in?
There's no actual process, like there's no set format of how we do things. I think we've been making music for so long. I think if we was to just kind of have one set way, we'd get bored quite easily. So
yeah,
it could be a combination of things. It could literally be I've started a demo, I send it to Connie, he likes it, he throws something on, he sends me a beat, it just could be literally anything. There's no rules, no regulations, yeah.
Which song off the Balance album would you say is your favourite?
I'd say at the moment, well, it was, someone asked me this I think 2 days ago and it was different to what it's been. Yeah, the title track, Balance, is probably what I'm listening to at this moment in time.
To be honest, me too, I've been rinsing the album since... Loyal fans, if you pre-ordered it,
yeah.
It dropped yesterday, yeah. So I spent the whole day in the sun just listening to the album on repeat.
Wicked.
I know you already know, like, lyrics. Like, you can recite more bars than I can. You're one that can learn those lyrics quick. I already know.
You know what, yeah. I think a couple of years ago, I kept buying Children's Zeus tickets and shouting my mates, and it got to a point where my boyfriend was like, I don't think I can go to this show, you know, Maya. I think I've seen Children of Zeus 4 times this year. I was like, what? Yeah. What do you mean? I felt insulted. I was like, I hadn't realised how many times I've been to your shows. So, yeah, I think I do know too many lyrics already. But which tune are you looking forward to performing the most, obviously? I know it's been locked down and we've all been inside, but off the album, because I know which ones I'm looking forward to listening to and hearing.
The ones that we always think beforehand when we're making the album, which will work live, it's not necessarily dictated by what we want to perform. It's more so which ones we find people really want to hear, and we test some out and they don't work as well as we think, and then there's some we just like think, oh, let's just try that one time, and they become the ones. It's like Hard Work, for instance, off Travel Light was never one I saw, be it just because of the pay. I think when we first started doing shows off Travel Light, we didn't even perform it, and I think now it's probably the yeah, song that probably the does
one.
The most.
Yeah.
Like, so it's just a case of we try trial and error a few of them, and also once the album comes out, we kind of work out which ones people like.
What's yours?
I'd probably say right now it would be California and Balance.
Okay.
But two different vibes.
Yeah.
Interesting.
See, I'd love to do, that's what I mean, the Cali Dreams one is probably one I'd love to do live, but yeah. I in my head the probably vocals. Doesn't work. Probably doesn't work live.
You've got to think as well, for us, it's like there's a difference between songs we can do on our own headline shows,
yeah,
and songs we can do, say, if we're doing a festival where there's going to be a load of people there for, you know, random acts or whatever. So, like, something like Cali probably wouldn't work for a crowd that doesn't know it.
But it'd work for an intimate show.
But for an intimate show and for people that know it,
yeah,
we can pretty much do anything off the album.
So I love the way on the live stream you guys did, like, remixes of your tunes with different beats and instrumentals. I feel like you could do an album based on that. You usually do that on shows as well, don't you?
Yeah, just a bit of fun, man. Just like traditional thing that's always, you know what I mean, remixes, putting different vocals over different beats, just keeps it exciting.
Yeah, definitely. So I feel like we keep talking about Balance. Shall we let them hear it?
Yeah, go for it.
Should we give it to the people?
Yeah.
Do you guys want to introduce it?
Which one are we playing? We're playing Balance, yeah, the song. Okay, Balance. This is the title song of the album Balance. And this song's called Balance, featuring Akemi Fox and Georgie Sweet, produced by K Caleb. Balance.
So I wanted to ask you as well, do you guys produce a lot of your music together? For
Our own music.
Yeah.
Yeah, we produce pretty much all of our... The plan was to just do... only our own production.
Yeah.
But Beat Butcher obviously messed it up because he's sick, so the guy sent us some beats and we just couldn't refuse it. And then, you know, a couple of other people have come through and done the same thing, but,
yeah,
you know, really 90% of what we do is all ourselves, like down to the production, the writing, the mixing, everything apart from mastering is literally just all in one room.
Is there anyone that you would like to collaborate with most? Anyone in the world?
There's a guy called, I think it's Konny Konny Kon or something like that. It's pretty good. I wouldn't mind doing something with him at some point.
Let me just say right now, it's not going to happen, mate.
Nah, you know what? There's a lot of... It's not even a case of anyone... There's obviously the dream collabs and all that kind of stuff or whatever, yeah. Which, to be fair, I imagine the fantasy would be a lot better than reality. So I'm not really in a rush to do any collabs. I'm more down with messing with kind of like younger artists from Manchester that are coming through, do you know what I mean? And just creating vibes with people that I already get on with, I've already got rapport with. That's all I'm really interested in, to be honest, just making classic music. Who it's with doesn't really matter as long as they're on the vibe.
I've noticed that you've got quite a few Manchester people that are, in my eyes, like the future bubblers that are just niche in their scene as well, and you work with them and you kind of spot those artists out from a mile away. And I think it's quite nice that you still work with them, even though you guys are so big in fans' eyes.
Well, to be fair, I think we see it as the other way around, because we see them, they're going to do way bigger things than what we're doing. So, plus, you know, there's a scene now that's developing in Manchester that has been for a while, that it's gonna last a long time, way beyond us. So for us to even, after being in it so long, to be able to take some of that energy and share it with them guys and kind of latch onto what they're doing almost, you know what I mean? It works both ways for us, definitely.
Definitely, but you're also inspiring them as well along the way, because I know a lot of other people look up to you and you also give a lot of opportunities to people. But who would you say out of Children's Zeus is the best chef?
Oh, that's not... this guy ain't even going to... I don't even open your mouth. This guy licks the plates when I make the food. I'm a bad man chef, that's all I'm saying.
So is one of you the joker and one of you the chef?
I think Tyler probably says both of them things, but
yeah,
I'm...
obviously.
Now, Tyler's like, I'm all right, man. Like, I'm not going to say I'm like dead in the kitchen, but...
You have never cooked no food for me.
I know, but... I don't have kids, man. I'm just gonna go and buy some food out my arse, innit? You know what I mean?
Sorry, I have to be a good cook, innit? I've got to pick me in that, so.
I hear that.
Tyler's a better chef. Yeah, can't lie. I'll give it to him.
So, Konny, a couple of years ago, you made a Facebook post and it was talking about the state of the jazz scene and the soul music in Manchester.
I'm going.
And you're saying how it was on its bottom.
No, it wasn't that.
Give me a taxi.
It wasn't that. Basically, I was a bit misguided by it, but what it was more saying was, at the time there was no unity or like any type of scene in Manchester.
That's in a whole though, not just in that scene. I feel like on a wide that was.
Nah, you know what?
I think he was referring to the London scene.
It was specifically just going to London and seeing how the London scene had made the jazz thing relevant again, and it wasn't seen as an old person kind of like middle class or, dare I say, a white thing. Do you know what I mean? Like it was what it should be, young, energetic, and it's black music at the end of the day.
Definitely.
Like, and there was people making it who weren't in like suits or weren't in like tight trainers. It was people that looked like us making jazz once again accessible to people who should be listening to jazz. So to me, in the Manchester scene, not that it didn't exist, but it just, there was no type of scene to me. And I was a bit wrong. There's people who can tell me there is a scene, but I was specifically talking about the way it was presented and the funding and just people pulling together to make it a thing. People told me I was wrong, and there was elements of it I was, you know, obviously I wasn't clued up, but the fact I wasn't clued up maybe says everything that needs to be said about it. As a guy who is very involved with what's going on in the Manchester music scene, the fact that I didn't know who any of the players were, and the players didn't know who any of the vocalists were, and no one was collaborating. Do you know what I mean?
Maybe you gave them that kick.
For about 5 minutes. it's in a similar place again, I feel like.
I was going to ask you, where do you think it is now? Is there much of a difference?
I speak to vocalists who make similar music to us all the time, who are always looking like, oh, I need a bass player, or I need someone that can come and play keys. And it's always a struggle.
Yeah.
And I feel like there's just a disconnect.
Yeah.
And you know, people said to me, like, at the time, like, as I say, I wasn't totally clued up, and people in the jazz scene said to me, yeah, but some of us don't want to do that. Some of us want to go and just play jazz without having to do neo soul and do hip hop. Like, we want to go and just play
in a band,
you know, 20 minutes of a keyboard solo and you know, it's a complicated one, and I'm not maybe not the right person to speak on it, but
well, you have.
I'm sorry, I'm blowing up now.
I've got a lot of stress about that from a lot of people. I deleted Facebook since then.
I'm getting anxiety.
Yo, Jazz World, I'm sorry, man.
Should I lighten it up a bit and talk about the colour show?
Let's do that. Clarinets and yeah, clarinet smashed over your head.
Yeah, colours, let's go. Go on, what you say?
So how did you find shooting the colour show? Because that is so exciting. I know everyone was so happy for you. It's colours.
Anxiety. Yeah. That's probably the
best. Like me today.
Yeah, just basically get over the. To be fair, we did it quite fast, didn't it?
Yeah.
I think we did about 3 takes. You just get to do a few takes and whichever one you like. Am I giving away the secret?
I wanted to find out. Let me tell you the secret.
Right, here's the thing, yeah. Really, yeah. People, because I wasn't sure. It's not mimed. Yeah. It's not pre-recorded.
That's one of my questions. Is it mimed?
It's not pre-recorded. And what you see on that video is the take of us recording it.
Yeah. That's amazing.
And it's one take.
Yeah, it's one take.
I do think with Children's Zeus, though, you can tell that it's live, not pre-recorded, and it is that take because you're singing your vocals, everything. You can't mime that.
Yeah. I think on ours you can, but I've seen somewhere, I wasn't sure. That's why when we went to do it, I wasn't even sure if it was pre-recorded. Like, I wasn't sure how it worked. And yeah, the mic is not photoshopped.
That was a rumor
that started about 2 years ago. I saw it all over, and people were like, look at it closely. I've zoomed in. There's no reflection on the mic. The mic is in front of me.
It's all genuine, man. So anyone you hear with a good vocal on there, that's literally them singing their heart out.
That is the beauty of colours.
Yeah,
crispiness.
Yeah.
That's why it's worth having that extra part put on Spotify to hear the cleanness of the vocal behind it all.
Definitely. It was only a small team as well in there, so it wasn't mad uncomfortable. There's only a few people there, you know what I mean, and very chilled, so big up to them, man.
Where was that filmed?
We did it in London, but usually it's based in Germany.
Berlin.
Yeah. So what shows are you most excited for when gigs are back opening up? Have you got anything you can
announced yet, but we've got a UK tour later in the year.
Oh my God. And in Manchester, obviously.
Of course.
That is super exciting.
Yeah, the dates will be announced real soon, but obviously, we're just everyone, you know, with all these things, no one just knows what's happening, but
I'm
hoping by the time these dates come around, things will be back to normal and we will be doing gigs. We've done a few gigs over the last few months. Like, we did two in London a couple of weeks ago, and we did a few in November. And they were all seated gigs, so it was a bit different. But we just want to get back to just doing some normal, like everyone hugging each other and crying and singing.
It's so strange, these seated gigs. I went to one at near home the other day, and we were all sat down, and everyone sat in tables, and the security running around making everyone sit down. It's like you're bringing everyone's energies up, but then the next minute you're having to stop the music, pull it up, and say, everyone, please sit down and calm until the whole room stands up and then they can't do anything.
We did something like November, and one of them was crazy. The people, obviously, they just got excited and just stood up. And I thought the security was just going to beat people up. And it's like, get down. It's crazy, man. It's weird.
It's a new world.
Yeah.
Let's put it like that. I know, Connie, you've got some DJ gigs coming up. Are they certain?
I've done a few over the last few weeks. I think I've done about 3 or 4.
Any of those dates you want to throw out there?
I wish I knew them.
Am I put you on the spot?
Yeah, I don't know the dates. Unless it's next week, I don't know what's going on. But I've got one in London coming up with Chimpo and DRS and Strats and a whole big drum and bass lineup. And I have got... I don't even know. Like, you have to come and find me on social media. I'm sure it's on there somewhere.
Do you want to tell the people where they can hit you up?
If you just come and find Children of Zeus on Twitter or Instagram, and then you can figure out the rest. You'll find me and Tyler off there. You can find us on Facebook, but you're not going to get much of a response on there, I'm afraid.
MySpace.
We haven't really got MySpace.
No.
I don't think many people do. It still exists, doesn't it?
I deleted my account about 3 months ago.
I haven't. I've still got, like, old pictures of me throwing ends up.
I know what I'm doing with my
ends aside and big massive jeans and stuff.
I'm going to find Tyler's MySpace.
I found mine and I was like, oh my god,
you can't tell it's me anyway. The pixels
like 4 pixels. I found mine and deleted it. It's crazy that these things just are going to exist in the world forever for you, like great great grandkids to find.
Man, don't remind me.
So in all of your time, and this is like one of my last questions for you, I know I'm keeping you for so long.
Nice, bless, but thank you.
What is the worst gig you've ever done?
Oh, man. What?
All right, here, I've got a story.
Should we just say as Children of Zeus? Because otherwise...
Could be here a while.
All right, I'm going to tell you one, yeah. It's not the worst, but it's up there with one of the worst, right?
Go on.
It's a bad and good story. So we travelled all the way to Switzerland to perform for like 7 people, right? And it was like 7 people who didn't know our music. So imagine doing...
Wait, 7 people? I just had to go back to the mic to actually speak.
Yeah, 7 people.
It might have been...
Probably including bar staff.
Yeah, it was crazy. Like, there was... And they all stood in a line in the middle of the... They stood in a line sideways facing us, like in the middle of the thing, like talking to each other. And we were just like, oh, can this show end? How long have we got left? Looking at my watch, like 7 hours left of this show.
Sweating now.
Sounds like a police lineup.
No, but... this show, yeah, was... It was one of the worst, right? But the thing was, the day after, we had one of the best days of our life. The promoter was like, all right, guys, I mean, I can take you out, or you can do what all the other rappers do when they come here and just stay in a hotel and do what rappers do. We're like, nah, let's go and see what, you know, this place has got to offer. And he took us up into the mountains, and we were in the Alps. And we had one of the best days, honestly, like, literally one of the best days. It's one of the most memorable days of my life. So with the bad... memories comes like one of the best memories, so I have to treat it like that. Like, with all the bad shows, there's usually a good element. Like, we might go and have like something good to eat or something.
Can I just remind you about the one we did in there? No. I don't even want to say what the area, I don't want to make it specific.
No,
make
anyone going.
Feel like, but it's one we did that was like a drum and bass thing. Like, everyone was twisted, like, it was like 3 a.m. Everyone's listening to like some jump up D&B, and then all of a sudden, Children of Zeus, like some slow jam.
No, it wasn't even. It got worse than that. They only had one mic.
Yeah, they had one mic.
There was people who was like in the front row, literally, you know, probably their second time out, twisted at their face.
Yeah.
And their faces as the D&B changed to like us doing slow jams.
People started crying, and that, you know, it's just a bit too much. He was like ruining whatever they was going through at the time. Yeah, it wasn't
bringing everyone down.
Yeah, exactly.
Real down.
We've done some bad ones.
We've done some funny ones, man. Yeah.
It sounds like it.
Yeah.
Have you guys got any special talents? Like, I feel like you guys play some secret instruments that we all should know about that you never tell.
I know bagpipes.
Tyler, I know you. Your bagpipe? Are you serious? No, you're playing with me.
No, I can't really play.
Yeah, you're lying, I know it. I'm too gullible.
Secret talents, you know what? Outside of making music, I'm literally useless.
Nah, come on. This guy.
Can you whistle?
The best whistle.
Wolf whistle or just whistling?
No, this guy's whistle is like a Disney. You know what I mean? Like Sleeping Beauty whistle.
I can whistle like an old man, but yeah, I can't do it on demand because I just start laughing.
You can't whistle.
It's like you have to catch me on the way out.
He's got the sickest whistle ever. So yeah.
It's like you know, like how old men whistle and they put like the little like this. Vibrato on it.
Yeah, with real soul.
Like proper, some
quivery. Do it, man.
Like Tyler's vocals, but on a whistle.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm hearing you now. Ben, can you please release the Children of Zeus dressing gowns, because we need that merch life. I need to be sat on my Sunday chilling to Children of Zeus in my dressing gown. Like,
you know what, we never really thought about making that a commercial thing.
You
it's
need
just
to make
really
it happen.
Personal thing.
Yeah,
that's how we get about most days in dressing gowns and slippers and
typical Zeus.
We should do that. You know what, our merch side is slacking. Some of the ideas that people have put to us, really, we should put into practice.
We'll make a promise there. We're gonna up our merch game.
Because even your hats are really nice, but they always sell out.
Yeah, that's the thing, man. We don't seem to do enough. I think we underestimate what we're gonna do. I think we have too much low expectations.
Humblest of all time comes to words.
Ever.
When you did it on the live stream, when you're saying ever repeatedly, I didn't get it until I got the album.
Yeah, it's the most humblest of all time.
Ever.
We should have put 2 evers at the end.
Yeah,
we
should have put 2 evers.
In capital, ever.
Yeah, exactly.
So yeah, the album is out Friday the 4th of June.
Yep.
It is out on Bandcamp. All the merch is there, physical, digital copies.
Yeah.
Have we got any videos to come? Obviously, you've also released Be Someone, and that the video was amazing. I used to live on the street where you filmed it. It literally brought me chills when I'm watching it.
Nice.
How did you come up with the concept of the video? This is like, I've literally squeezed another question in.
We're going to give that to
Farrow.
Carl John.
Yeah.
Yeah, big shout out to Carl John, aka Farrow, who's done I've done quite a few videos for you. He did our first video.
Is it Slow Down?
He did Slow Down. He did Still Standing. He did Hard Work. Yeah, he's done quite a few for us, and he's going to do a couple more as well. So, yeah, there's going to be more videos. I think we just struggle with visuals, innit? Like, we're just not guys that like to be on camera.
You say that, but then all your videos are amazing, like, breathtaking. So I feel like you need to share more.
Yeah, but we're trying not to be in them. We every time we shoot videos these days, we're just like, can we do a video where it's just a story and we're not in it?
I wish we kind of had just started off with two other, you know, like Milli Vanilli, just got two younger...
Yeah,
guys that really love being in the camera, and we could just on the music in the background.
Yeah.
I think that would have been more.
It's never too late to start a new group, you know. We can do that and put KSR in the front.
Well, thank you so much for coming through. It's been amazing to have you through on the show.
Thank you for having us.
I'm gonna take us out with the humblest of most time ever. I think I just said it wrong as well.
Something like that.
Yeah,
the most humble of all time. The most humblest of all time. Ever.